Welcome back to the home bar situation. We're gonna be making a carajillo today. So what is a carajillo? It's a really popular, awesome, simple cocktail from Mexico. You can get it in almost any bar in Mexico City or Oaxaca. It's espresso and liquor 43. Liquor 43 is from Spain. It's got a lot of 43 herbal botanicals, but really you get a lot of vanilla and some sweetness from that. So that was some really acidic, bitter, lovely espresso, and you kind of cut through all that sweetness and you get the vanilla tones, and it's just a beautiful combination. For the longest time, Esuerte, since we don't have an espresso machine, we weren't offering carajillos, but people kept asking for them because it is such a great cocktail. So what we did, we got with our friend Richard from Fleet, and he helped us develop a really strong cold brew concentrate toddy. And so now it's just like, you know, good times. We have the carajillo now, and we get them calls for them a lot still. So let's go ahead and make one as you would in your kit. This is going to be a slightly larger version than what we do at the restaurant. We'll review what the restaurant does directly after this. So we're going to do 2 ounces of liquor 43. We'll do 2.5 ounces of the cold brew toddy. You could put it in something to make it easier to pour. And just some ice. Here's your fucking drink, chef.
You know, Blake, I don't drink a lot of coffee. I actually don't drink coffee.
You don't drink any coffee. Anytime.
Ever. This is the only time I drink coffee, and I don't drink a lot of carajillos in general, but every time I'm in Mexico, I always find myself drinking a carajillo. You know why?
Why's that?
Because it's like, it's a perfect after dinner drink. Once you ate a lot of delicious food, you ate a lot of tacos, a lot of greasy things, and it's about 6-ish, it's a Friday night, and this is the perfect thing to get you from point A to point B. That is why I enjoy carajillos, so thank you.
Yeah, you're a little bit heavy after the meal, and then you're ready to go do something else, maybe walk somewhere, grab one of those, you're good to go.
Either that, or it's also great for brunch.
It is good for brunch, sorry. So at Suerte, we incorporate an egg white, and you're gonna wanna use a method called the reverse dry shake to get that frothy. Why add an egg white? It's just really nice, pillowy, luscious foam that stays around for a while. So we'll go ahead and separate this one whole egg white out. We do a little bit smaller of a build to compensate for the volume that the egg white gives the cocktail. So I'm gonna do 1.25 ounce of liquor 43. And then a nice 1.5 of the cold brew toddy. To perform a reverse dry shake, you're gonna go ahead and put ice in there. And shake it as normal. Strain the ice out of the cocktail back into half of your shaker. And now, this is what we mean by dry shake. There's no ice in here, and we're just gonna really fluff that egg white up now. Thank you.
Fine strain over some fresh ice.
If you had to choose, which one would you choose out of both of these?
I prefer the egg white. What do you think?
I think I do too. Just the mouthfeel is so much better, you know?
Luscious.
Plus, if you don't want to like whip out the double sink and double shake and all that stuff, like this is just as good too, you know?
That's a classic for a reason. You can get it almost any bar you go to.
Yeah.
In Mexico.
I mean, if you're going to be my bartender, egg white it is.
Boom.
Boom.